No, ¿para qué?
Entonces, no se va a alcanzar a conectar todo todavía. Si quiere transmitir así, falta.
¿Qué queda para el micrófono?
Sí.
¿Pero el micrófono dijo que no es, no funciona?
Funciona. Pero está muy sencillo. Esto es,
¿no se puede mover aquí?
Sí, sí se puede. Sí, sí.
Expediciones. Okay, la copia. Y con el español.
Parish and St. Charles Borromeo, or St. Charles Borromeo Parish and St. Roman combined online masses. We welcome you this, the fourth Sunday of Easter, as we celebrate the wonderful resurrection of the Lord still. Our presider today is Father Carlos. Please greet those around you in your homes, give a friendly hello to your brothers, your sisters in Christ, and we warmly greet you from here in the church. Our opening hymn for today is number 609 from the Blue Hymnals, You Are the Voice. All of the words to all of our hymns can be found in the comment or in the description below your YouTube video today.
With humility, we say, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary and the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray.
Almighty, very big God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns
with you
in the unity of the
Holy Spirit,
one God,
forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Of the apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ, this Jesus whom you crucified." Now, when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and your children, and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. For you have gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Praise be to God. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said, Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. And the shepherd calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven out all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him, because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him, because they do not recognize the voice of strangers. Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus said again, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pastures. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please take a seat. My dear friends, today in our fourth Sunday of Easter is a beautiful opportunity to pray and recognize that Jesus compared our relationship with him like he's a good shepherd and we are a sheep. So today is to pray for the good shepherds. And you know that we had a shepherd in our Archdiocese of Milwaukee, which we is taking. And we have three Australian bishops, and we have priests and deacons, and all the people working together, and religious and men and women, to work together to protect the flock, to protect all the sheep. And today is just to pray for spiritual leaders, because it's that continuing together our faith and our community together. And then today we have beautiful leaders that invite us to continue to understand if we are sheep, Jesus our shepherd, we need to stay close to him. And the first reading, Peter again and again tried to talk about Jesus, to explain to the people what is his faith, what is his proclamation. The good news is about Jesus, he's alive. And then he said that we receive the Holy Spirit in our baptism. Because from our baptism, we become a member of the family, God's family, children of God. So we are just one community, one flock, and we follow and we listen just one voice, Jesus Christ. He's the good shepherd. So we need to pay attention, to keep silent, and try to listen to just one voice. And this time we have many voices, many distractions in the world that confuse us. And we need to clarify what is the correct voice that I need to pay attention. Just the good shepherd, Jesus Christ. The connection is the Holy Spirit. We receive the Spirit in our baptism, and we continue close to Jesus in our spiritual life. We receive the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit is the connection with God. It's the same way, that's like we have a cell phone, and then I need to charge, because it's not working correctly. We need to charge the cell phone. It's just a new battery, and put the cell phone charging. It's to receive energy, to receive power, to work correctly. We need Jesus Christ as the power, our energy, and we have connection with Jesus Christ because we receive the Holy Spirit that he offers us in our baptism. So today I invite all of you to recognize that we receive the Holy Spirit and we keep the Holy Spirit in our heart, in our minds, in our lives. It's just to recognize I am children of God, we are children of God, we receive the Holy Spirit, we just have connection with God because we belong to his family. And then, if we are now serving the mass from your house, and then it's just to wait, trust in God. Why? Because he's saying the gospel, I am the gate. Gate is the door. Door is a symbol of security. Close the door and you feel safe. The door is a symbol of protection. The family built the door and see protection. The door is a symbol of freedom. I can open the door and go away. It's a symbol of freedom. So Jesus is my freedom. Jesus is my protection. It's my everything. It's the invitation today to recognize he said in the gospel, I am the gate. And please, if you go, you need to cross through me. I am the gate. The door is a symbol of these things. Protection, security, freedom, trust. It's just, and this made us to recognize Jesus is the door. I need to cross by through him. So in this mass, I invite you to continue praying together. And we receive the good news from Jesus of walking that we will start a new mass. We open the church and we organize the day. The people come little by little, but it's the hope that we start again in our Catholic Church on May 31st. It's the Pentecost Sunday. So I invite all of you for now to pray for our Catholic Church, because we will start a new Pentecost Sunday. It's a new start. The Holy Spirit is in us, is working in us, and is between us. It's just to pray for our Catholic Church, because around the world, we need to open the door again in our temples and welcome everybody. And you are welcome to come back to your church, your community, your parish, because we love you and we miss you. So we are preparing everything to open the door just for you, because you are part of what belongs to this parish. And we're very happy to open the door on May 31st to preside in Mass for all of you. Little by little, come to Mass and we'll receive more information on how we are going to organize the Mass. The Mass is, but it's just to pray for that moment, because it's a step to come back together. So today is a Good Shepherd's Day to pray for our Pope Francis, pray for the bishop, especially our bishop in Jerusalem, pray for all the priests, and pray for the parents in house, because in your family, you are the good shepherd. You need to be a good shepherd, because you have a small flock. Your children is like a sheep, and you need to protect them. You are the gate, you are the door. You need to feel and to offer to them security, protection, freedom, trust, love, peace, compassion, everything. This is the simple door. The door is everything. Jesus is our door. So in this mass, I invite you to pray together and recognize that what important is Jesus as a good shepherd, and try to listen the good news, just his voice. Not many voices are confusing. It's just one voice, Jesus Christ. And today Jesus said to us, I am the gate, and try to enter through him. In the Mass, it's an opportunity to recognize Jesus, come to my family. I open my heart, they open the door of my heart to receive you spiritually. Come to me, come to my marriage, come to my family, because we need you. Open the door. And you have opened the door in your family, because Jesus is coming to visit you, to visit your family, to bless us. Why? Because he loves us so much. Today is an opportunity to pray for our spiritual leaders, and we continue together and pray for our Catholic Church, especially for our Church in Milwaukee, that will start in May 31st to open the door just for you. Welcome from now. We ask our Mother Virgin Mary to intercede for us today, tomorrow, and always, to open our hearts, because Jesus is the gate. He's our Savior, our good shepherd. And we need to be a good shepherd to stay just close to him. Amen. Please rise, and now we profess our faith in Jesus Christ. We confidently we say, I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, for all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnated in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified and Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and I see that the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will be in no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead in the life of the world to come. Amen. And now we present to Jesus our petitions with faith and hope.
Through Jesus, the shepherd and guardian of our souls, let us intercede for the needs of all God's flock. That all Christians, baptized in the name of one Lord, may hear and heed the voice of the shepherd who calls us to unity, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our young people may find in our community an authentic and attractive witness to the joy of life in Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord in heaven, be close to those who assist the sick night and day, and protect the priests who, in their pastoral concern and fidelity to the gospel, are trying to help and support everyone, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who suffer for their witness against injustice and greed may take heart and follow in the nonviolent ways of Christ, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our first communicants who would have been receiving the Eucharist for the first time this weekend, we pray that they are continuing their spiritual growth during this difficult time, as they await the day when they can join together at the altar to partake of the richness of the Lord's gifts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we who are being called by our Good Shepherd may have courage to follow and openness to welcome all others who hear his call, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may entrust our beloved dead, especially Patricia Kubanski, to the one who judges justly, so that they may have life and have it abundantly, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Christine Krasick, Joseph and Violet Pollock, and the parishioners of St. Charles Borromeo and St. Roman, whom we remember in today's Mass, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers written in the prayer book, Ministry of Praise, and on the prayer chain, and for those held in the silence of our hearts, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty God, we thank you for listening to us. We present to you these petitions through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please.
Thank you.
agreement, brothers and sisters, of my sacrifice and yours.
May be acceptable
to God and the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and for all his holy church. Grant that we pray, O Lord,
that we may
always find
delight in
these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work
within us
may
be the cause
of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us
give thanks to the Lord,
our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just.
Our duty and our
salvation. At all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but at this time and above all, to love
you yet more gloriously.
When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us by defense
us and ever please
our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelical hosts sing it
together,
the connecting hymn of your glory as they acclaim. So that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At that time he was betrayed, and entering willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." My Lord and my God, I believe. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." My Lord, and my God, I believe. the mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give and thank you that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring the heart of the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jerome, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Remember our loved ones and our brothers and sisters for our parishes, St. Charles and Romans, for whom we offer these men. All who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, and our Mother, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, St. Romans, St. Charles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. As a family, a small flock, we pray together the same prayer that Jesus taught us. With confidence, we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. Let us offer each other the sign of peace, please. I offer again my communion for all of you, and invite all of you to prepare yourself to receive a special communion this mass. It's just to recognize Jesus is a good shepherd. I need to open the door to my heart, because Jesus is coming to us. Jesus is coming to your home to listen to you. Prepare yourself, prepare your family to receive Jesus in this mass. With faith and devotion, we prepare ourselves to receive a spiritual communion, and again, I receive my communion just for all of you. My friends, thanks. And Jesus Christ, our Savior, our friend, and our God. He is the good shepherd. Don't be afraid to know Jesus, to love him, and to follow him. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that I should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. in thanksgiving for this communion, we meditate together, please. Soul of Christ, sanctify me. Body of Christ, save me. Blood of Christ, inebriate me. Water from the side of Christ, watches me. Passion of Christ, strengthen me. O God Jesus, hear me. Within your wounds, hide me. Separated from you, let me never be. From the evil one, protect me. At the hour of my death, call me. And close to you, beg me, that with your saints, I may be praising you forever and ever. Amen. Please rise. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle an eternal pasture. The sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless you and all your families. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. My brothers and sisters, the day has ascended, we continue in peace. Thanks be to God. We consecrate our families, our parish, to our Mother Virgin Mary, and we say to her, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among us women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Have a beautiful evening, my friend. Thank you for joining us. And then I will to wait for you next Saturday, this weekend. And then please prepare to see us, to see me in the Mass, to pray together. Thank you. God bless you. I love you. Ciao, ciao.